Good morning. Thank you to the three of you to joining the AWS studio today.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Let's start with a round of intros, maybe starting with you, Eyal.
Oh, thank you. So my name is Eyal Ullert. I'm working for Voipfuture in Germany, in Hamburg, and I'm doing the business development. That's part of my main role in the company. And on top of it, we are doing voice service assurance, looking on the service provider network for voice quality issues that they may have, especially on new technology, VoIP, VoLTE, VoNR. This is what we do.
Wonderful. Thanks for joining us. And let's turn it over to our fellow Amazonians, starting with Aymen and then over to you, Gorsel.
Hey, hi. I'm Aymen Saidi. I'm a principal solution architect within the EC2 Edge team, mainly focusing on everything 5G new initiative, and automation, as well as OSS application.
Wonderful.
Hey, my name is Gorsel Baksi, and I work as senior partner development manager inside our industry vertical partner management organization, focusing with our telco ISV partners.
Thank you all for the warm intros. Of course, we're here today to talk about how AWS partners are enabling innovation for end customers. So I think we need to understand that partner journey a little bit better. And so starting with you, Eyal, tell me about your cloud journey. Tell me, and first, what were you hearing from your customers that really kicked off that cloud journey to begin with?
Actually, with us was really spot on. So our customer took us to the journey. So they said, okay, we have some new project coming on AWS, and we would like you to help us migrate some of your solutions also to the cloud. So we've been reached out to all available cloud vendors. Immediately, we got a good pickup from AWS. I think after a few days when we started the journey, was taking over the technical leadership. Technical leadership is the most critical part on the journey of any ISV towards AWS or any other cloud vendors. You need to really understand the technical behind it. What does it mean to migrate software to make it more cloud native? And in that journey, basically, we were involving all company, I would say, functions, like, for example, R&D, which is one of the key leader in this journey. And then, of course, the business development to see what will be your main offering in the cloud. So this was the journey for us.
So technical proficiency clearly being a key prerequisite for earning trust with you to build that solution. What else do you value most in cloud partners?
The speed of how things done. So from the moment we took the journey until the moment we become an ISV partner and even an ISV Accelerate partner, it took really several months. So this was completely amazing. And more on top of it, we managed to acquire customers within the journey, moving some of our, let's say, existing customers, but also new customers. This was really exciting.
Can already tell by the smiles in the room. This clearly isn't the first time the three of you have been in a room together. It's wonderful. So let's start with you, Gorsel. Talk to me about the strategy of engaging partners. How did you earn trust with the partner?
I think the key to that, Robert, is about finding the same language. I think this is what we're now in AWS getting much better, because we're building these domain expertise in our partner team. So I worked in the similar organizations like Eyal does for pretty much all my career. So it's the ideal piece is about how do we speak the same language with our partners that are focusing in this telco industry. So we have a small team that are actually experts in the domain and also knows about the challenges companies like AL's company face. So it makes us easy to understand each other. We speak the same language, we know the issues, we know the challenges. And really, the idea here is, we'd like to help build growing, profitable businesses on AWS and help solve our customers' challenges in the telco industry, help them move to the next level. And this is where I think we try to help them on the go-to-market. But before go-to-market, we really have to focus on the get-to-market. And get-to-market is the piece where I think Eyal, for example, excels at. He actually did the whole journey, as he explained, in so crisp fashion. We help them, we guide them how to get to market with AWS. But at the end of the day, it takes two to tango. And Eyal does a great job in tangoing with us as well.
You're just rolling with sound bites here. I love it. get to market before you go to market. So maybe in the spirit of getting to market, turning back over to you, Aymen, as we worked through the technical solutioning, you're hearing about these challenges. What was the playbook?
I mean, playbook is quite simple, right? So First, we have really to show the case that we have competence within AWS telco team, right? So we know our stuff, we know the cloud, but we also know telco. So we're able to manage both the cloud and the telco challenges, right? We also start with our customers, right? So by knowing the industry, by knowing what our customer are looking for, by learning the challenges of our customer, we're actually able to earn trust from our partners and then guide them into modernizing the architecture so they can get the agility, the efficiency, the cost optimization. So ultimately having a solution that is better with the customer. So we ultimately always start with the customer. We look at their challenges, we look at the challenge of the customer, and then we apply the competence that we have in-house. It's all the teams that we have, all the organization efficiency that we have, and we bring that to the partnership. And ultimately, that's what we did with Voipfuture.
So let's take it one level deeper. From a technical perspective, what did we actually build, and how did we do it?
So Voipfuture, do you want to speak a little bit of the Voipfuture solution, and then we take the use case is quite interesting?
So I think what we bring also to the AWS environment is quite unique and very interesting for the service provider's domain. So we bring user experience. So you're now opening up new services, run them on the cloud. You're entering into a bigger platform. And then the service itself become the most important for the service providers. You're now providing new services, and you want to make sure that all your customers are always getting the right level of service that you envision. So this is basically what we do. And we are looking on the voice traffic, and we are able to generate the right information to the service provider, but also to any, let's say, service operations, the reporting that they need to do. And then they can take action based on that. And this is really basically what we're doing essentially.
Data gravity has been a huge theme that we've been talking a lot about, and that seems to align with exactly what you're saying. Data when the operators need it. Talk to me about some other business impacts that your team experienced.
So the most interesting business impact was that one of our existing customers had the idea to deploy a new service in the AWS. It was actually a technical endeavor, not a commercial endeavor. And this was really fantastic. We love technical challenge, and we all immediately, yes, let's do a new service in the cloud. And everybody was interested. And then in a point of time, I was like, okay, maybe let's have a joint team. So tier one service operator, I'm talking about really one of the large international voice platform in the world that is one of our key customer. And I asked for a meeting with the product owner and the AWS leadership team in that time. So we all met and sat in the room. I was enjoying the conversation because in that time, the tier one service provider was talking directly to the AWS. And I think it took them maybe 20 minutes of conversation. And then the product owner from this customer was saying to the AWS guy, really, you're telling me now that my typical connection of a customer is 8-9 months? Now I can do it in days? And in that point, I understood the conversation is over. That's it. The project was launched.
And if I may add, actually, for this one, that's why I love this partnership, right? So ultimately, it's to innovate with the customer. So this is not their core business, but it's also nothing that we thought of, right? So ultimately, customer has a problem. It's not ultimately what Voipfuture does, and we don't necessarily had that in our radar. But with that strong partnership, right, that trust that we were able to earn, we're able to talk with the customer and really have a meaningful conversation so we can set workshops and then set the motion to create something that is completely new and that is really helping the tier one operator to deliver a service, right, or an old service that they have following the old way in a much faster way. And that's why, like, I value these type of partnership. It just, you can innovate for the customer so quickly.
So it's those cross-functional workshops. It's what gets us to market. But from a go-to-market perspective, starting with you, Gorsel, what were some of the tactics and techniques that we leveraged?
Right. I think, as I mentioned, one of the key things that Eyal did perfectly was to ensure that we earn trust with the customer by making sure we have a well-architected solution that is optimized for deployment on AWS. They immediately, very quickly on, earned their foundational technical review, which is actually a critical part of the tactics in terms of going to market and ensuring earning trust with the customers. And the next thing we have done and we're working on as well currently is to get to join up that whole commercial model with AWS Marketplace. So Eyal will shortly be on AWS Marketplace, offering his offering on AWS Marketplace that gives customers a better mechanism to acquire such software, find that such software that exists, and then deploy, acquire very agile, in a very agile manner to meet their demands and needs. So that's, I think that's part of the key part in terms of our joint go-to-market. ISV Accelerate is another key program AL is leveraging now. In terms of addressing a joint go-to-market, I think these are the key areas, you know, earning FTR, becoming an ISV Accelerate partner, getting onto marketplace. I think these are the three key motions that we, you know, we expect our partners to work with us and help them go-to-market story.
I want to dive a little deeper into the marketplace story here. But before that, as we think about that go-to-market motion, it seems to me that this is more B2B or B2B2X. Does AL's journey align with our broader strategy for some of these newer enterprise solutions and B2B2X models?
I believe so, because what's AL's offering quite interesting is it actually helps telecom operators to offer better quality voice services. Another key part of that is as well that he offers a very interesting solution to call centers. Now, the telco industry and call center industry are also merging as well. The telcos offering call centers as a service. And this is where AL's offering will be, I think, in an elevated manner, will become more important for telcos, especially when they offer these call centers as a service offerings to big enterprises. And so I think that's where the interesting, you know, 1+1=3 equation comes in, where AL's offering will be significantly more valuable for telcos, not only for their B2C customer base, but also for their B2B and B2B2X business.
Well, I'm going to challenge AL to see if we can make 1+1=4. And so to that end, as you think about AWS Marketplace or our broader set of solutions that we can offer to partners, what's most attractive to you about the AWS partner network more broadly?
Good question. I think that here the basically what we see in front of us already, I have some examples. We bought ourselves a very interesting new market that was not open to us, especially not from the speed and the from the broad spectrum of new customers. I'm talking more to a call center, but it's not only. So it's everybody. As enterprise running is voice services, and now they do it in the cloud. And this is a journey that they already, all of them, been taking. Now, marketplace will be it will be a game changer from Voipfuture perspective, but also from customer perspective. And I will give an example. Not long ago, we got an urgent email during weekend, typically don't work in the weekend. So I said, yeah, I'm at home, I will pick up. It was American customer, so it was a very late night for me. And we had, after a few exchange of email, a phone call already on Saturday. By Sunday, the application from us was installed. We needed to do it because we are not yet a marketplace enabled. We needed to do it remotely by our team, but it's quite simple. And the story from the customer that he made a new interconnect. And since then, it was a week before he contacted us, and none of his operation team are getting any sleep. Customers are complaining, shouting, and they have no clue how to identify what is the issue. Sunday, the product was installed. Monday, we already told him what's the issue, and everything. I think Tuesday, we already got the order.
Rapid pace of innovation.
Yeah, this is like, In our case, it's imaginary. It's not. It was never exist before.
We talk a lot at AWS, the ability to experiment quickly, try something new, and then rapidly permute on that experiment to find the solution that's best with customers. Perfect anecdotal evidence here. Really appreciate you sharing that anecdote. From your perspective, Aymen,
yep.
What are other early customer use cases that you expect from the solution, particularly as it gets deployed to marketplace?
No, absolutely. So I'll basically pause for a second just to go back to one of the answer that we had with one of the tier one, but also with this use cases that AL has been speaking to. One of the cool thing that we have been doing is we've been able to build solution that really go through the edge continuum. So when you're talking about voice, right, you're talking a lot about the analysis being done on cloud in region. We're also talking about deploying the probes in essence across the network, closer to the network, or even further away from the network. And what we've been able to do is Voipfuture that has really enabled those business opportunities is we'll be able to build a solution. And specifically with that case where we had a workshop with the tier one operator, building a solution that is replicable, not only in region, not only in a VPC for one customer, but for even including VPC for customer of customers, right? So that B2B2B, but also to local zone and outpost. And that unlocked selling to multitude of enterprise across really the globe, right? So for that tier one operator that has customer all around the globe, right? So it's a big tier one operator, we're still able to expand the amount of customer that can benefit from the Voipfuture solution. And ultimately, that's what the AWS infrastructure, that AWS Edge Continuum enable, and what the AWS services and the partnership that we have enable our partner to innovate for our customers.
Wonderful. So let's zoom out for a second. Where's the partnership going, Gorsel, in your view?
Look, I think this is one of those interesting areas because once we get to the marketplace and once Eyal sprinkles a little bit of that AI ML sauce into his offerings, that will actually be a game changer for Eyal's business, and that will elevate the partnership as well. I think I see them in the next, and hopefully when we sit here next year, I see some of these things, some of these stories will come alive with some great Lighthouse customer references, and those are the things that we will start turning the flywheel. And in the next 3 years, if you look at the 3-year horizon, I see this partnership at a whole different level.
Next level of Voipfuture, Aymen, what are you seeing?
We already start talking about the next level of the partnership and what we can do, right? The use cases that we can apply. We're looking at what we can do together with additional partners of AWS and our customers to potentially expand beyond the voice, right? So beyond voice analysis and improving the voice quality and identifying where the issue are across the network. So what I view within that partnership and what we can do, I think it's to be seen, and hopefully a year from now we'll have something pretty cool to showcase.
I want to give the final word to you, Eyal. Next level of Voipfuture in the partnership with AWS.
I'm joining Gorsel with the Aymen story. I think what the key, what we do for our customer, basically, we're producing the very accurate data to take them to the next level. And next level for every service operator is reducing cost by automated services. And basically with this partnership, this is what we can do. This is our vision. This is going forward. This is something that we want to achieve.
Fantastic story here today. Thank you for taking a journey with us. We can't wait to see what you build. Thanks for joining us all in the AWS studio, and hope
Thank
we have
you.
A chance to connect soon.
All right. Thank you, Robbie. Appreciate
Thanks.
It.